Hi, I'm Rick Dahman with Timken. In a previous video, we talked about the importance of recommending high quality bearing sets and wheel hub units for your truck customers. Your customers with light and medium duty work trucks need reliable, premium quality replacement bearings. However, recommending high quality bearings from a trusted manufacturer is just part of the equation for avoiding customer comebacks. If a hub unit isn't installed properly, you could be hearing from your customer sooner rather than later. Regardless of the quality of the product, with that in mind, let's take a look at three important things that your customers need to pay close attention to when they're installing that new hub assembly that you just sold them. The first is axle nut torque. Loss of bearing retention is the leading cause of hub bearing damage, and often this goes back to improper torque of the axle retaining nut. Too little or too much torque on the axle nut changes the geometry or the angle of pressure for the bearing inside the hub. If the angle of pressure isn't optimal, you can get wear and play. Even a slight variance can mean the difference between long bearing life or a failure in a few thousand miles. That's why it's critically important for your customers to tighten the axle nut to the proper torque based on the OEM specifications. They can refer to the service information or visit timkeninfo.com to identify the proper torque. Also, they should always use a new axle retaining nut. Reusing the old nut could potentially cause the nut to loosen during vehicle operation. The second thing they want to pay close attention to is the ABS wheel speed sensor cable. If the truck is equipped with an ABS sensor cable, it is important to make a note of the proper orientation and positioning of the sensor wire and bearing before removing the hub unit. Then they can disconnect the ABS sensor wire from its mating connector point and positioning clips, which are usually located in the wheel well or on the chassis frame. When installing the new hub assembly, they need to take extra care not to damage the ABS sensor cable. They also need to make sure that the sensor cable is properly positioned in the clips and to its mating connection point. If the ABS wheel speed sensor fails because it's been damaged or routed improperly, that's going to lead to a customer comeback in an unsafe situation for the driver. The third item involves a type of wrench that your customer used to remove and install the hub assembly. We talked earlier about the importance of following the vehicle manufacturer's recommended torque specs for the axle retaining nut and/or the lug nuts. It's just as important to use the right wrench. In this case, it's not recommended to use an impact wrench, even though it might seem easier. Timken recommends using a certified calibrated torque wrench. An impact wrench can damage the threads on the axle shaft and the retaining nut, and it can cause damage to the internal components of the bearing. It also can create a false sense of security when adjusting a nut or bolt, which may be under or over torqued. This can leave a hub assembly susceptible to failure. As a counter pro, you're the first line of defense against the comebacks and parts returns. And that's especially important with your truck customers who count on their vehicle for their livelihood. That's why it's good to be aware of some of the key installation issues that your customers need to stay on top of so they can maximize the performance and life of their bearing hubs. And always make sure you recommend high quality bearing sets and hub assemblies that keep them out in the field earning money instead of in the repair shop costing them money. Thanks for watching.